Okay, so round two in my trials or tests of different ways to use a wood gas stove. In this case, the wild wood gas stove, I believe it's called. So once again, I brought some some noise. And a couple of pieces of wood that are conveniently placed in the sort of wood caches that the municipalities have around here. The trial this time is to cut those pieces so that each piece will be placed standing, and the length of the pieces shall be so that it's just a bit below the secondary inlet holes. And I'll try to more or less pack the entire volume with those. And on top of it, some shavings and stuff to get the fire going. And just see how it works, how it performs with that type of fire, positioning of the fire. One drawback of these municipality things, fireplaces, is people that are idiots and can't be bothered to remove their garbage after them. But still, this is the place I'm going to be today. So, next up, cutting pieces and preparing the wood, the fuel. So that's next step. Now for some sawing and splitting. Okay, just to give you an idea of the volume of fuel, I took this piece, which is about, I don't know, 3 centimeters by 7, 8, something like that. And I have cut off 2 pieces that are each about 10 centimeters long, and split those into roughly these dimension sticks. So next is to prep the stove with the fuel. And this is the result. As you can see, it's a fairly dense packing, not much movement left, so that was pretty much an ideal amount of fuel. So these are standing up directly on the bottom of the stove, nothing in between. And next is to put some Vaseline cotton balls and shavings on top of that. So the idea is that the shavings shall take fire and set fire to these, and after a while the woodification, the gasification of these pieces of wood should start. So we continue. Okay, so we have everything prepped and ready to go. The fuel, the Vaseline cotton balls and some shavings on top of that. So I'll set fire to the whole thing and hope it works as intended. Okay, so the fire has just been started, and it's at this point only the shavings that is burning. So we'll let them do their thing and hope that the actual fuel starts to gasify and get the process started. Yeah, so a quick pause and I'll get back soon. Figured we could put some timing here. Let's say that I set the fire at 10 to 7. So that's when I lit the whole thing, 10 to 7. Rather clean burning flame, not much smoke, if any. But the real test comes if the fuel starts to gasify. And this is just wood taken from a municipal cache. So no telling of the how humid it is, how dry it is. Just what I got there. Okay. A couple of minutes later, 5 minutes in, and it starts to look like we have some jets beginning to build from the sides. I'm not sure how the visibility is on camera, but it's starting to build up those jets. And well, it seems to get things going here. We'll continue watching. About 9 minutes in, and I just put on a pot of water, and the fire looks like this now. It's picking up the pace. Not sure how long it will last, but that's part of the test in this case. So just to put something, let it do some use. A bit wobbly. So the point is not to measure times to boil water or anything like that. Perhaps see how clean this burns or not. The pot is fairly, it has some, it's not super clean, but it's not sooty from the beginning. So we shall see how it looks like afterwards. So, yeah, everything looks good. As you can see, there's a little bit, a small breeze, which isn't helping things, but I let it be as it is. Normally I try to put something to block the wind here, but we'll leave it as it is. So about 30 minutes in, and I'll remove the pan as well. I just need to put on a glove. But as you can see, a fair amount of jets. It doesn't seem like all the holes are producing jets, as you can see back there. And there's a fair amount of burning on further down on the sticks. So we'll continue. So one of the purposes of this test is basically to see how if this works, which it does, and secondly how long time, how long burn this type of fuel stacking will give me. So it's now about 20 minutes after I lit everything up, and the jets of fuel, I'm not sure how much it sees, but they're starting to decay. And as I peer down, probably don't see it, as I peer down into the stove, the fire is pretty much gone and the fuel is spent. Let's see if I can get the lid off. And the water is just getting to boil.
so it worked, but I had hoped for a bit more longer burn time. This obviously depends on what type of wood you use as fuel. Also, as you may or may not see, there's not much soot. There's this coloring. This pan is just a piece of crap pan, thin metal, and there's a bit of discoloring, but that's more from the heat than from soot. So yeah, I would have hoped for a longer burn time, but this is what you got. Enough to boil up some water. I think I had about a half liter of water in there, 500 ml. Okay, so 25 minutes after starting the fire, the heat from the embers was just holding the water bubbling, but I decided to not waste the piece of wood that I left, so I just chopped it up in rough pieces and tossed something thin in here just to demonstrate what happens if we do that, if anything happens. So I had a small shaving from that piece, so that's what's burning at this time. But the residual heat from the embers should be enough to get things started again. And this is much thicker pieces, as you can see, and not cut to length. So, a couple of centimeters sticking up top, and quite thick pieces as well, so not in the most efficient way, perhaps. Then again, maybe it would last longer if I had thicker pieces. That's one of the fun things of testing, trying what works and what doesn't work. The best way is to get out there and experiment and try and see what works for you. So I'll just fill up the stove. Not perhaps the prettiest way to do it, but this is pretty much just to get rid of it, of the wood, not let it go to waste. Now, for pretty much the first time, there is smoke being produced and coming off. There was no smoke when I lit the fire. So this is the first time there's any smoke being produced. And obviously these pieces are definitely too long for best efficiency, but that's the way it is. And just to demonstrate what happens to the pan, the deposits here is, as you can see, pretty shiny, so not sooty. It's very shiny. I'm sure some chemist can explain it exactly what it is, but it's not sticky. It's not sticky here. Obviously deposits, but not soot. Gives a dark color, quite beautiful actually. And this guy is up and running again, so obviously having fuel pointing up above the lid here, above the top, is really the way to do it, but there you have it. So that pretty much concludes this test, this trial. Not really sure what my conclusions are, if it's better to have shorter pieces and more or less stack them horizontally, if that provides a bit more of a like a layering effect, so you have the fire bed on top working its way down and having gasification going on below the fire bed. In this case, with the sticks standing up, they quite quickly burnt down. So it worked. It burned, well, efficiently for between 15 and 18 minutes, not including the lighting process, the ignition process. So next time, because the first time when I did the shorter pieces and stacked them, well, lay them horizontally, I didn't have time to let that fire burn all the way through. So I'll go back to that type of fuel and see how that performs compared to these standing pieces. And again, obviously results will differ depending on the type of wood as well, but just to get some general ideas. So I think that will conclude this video. Hope you enjoyed, and see you later.